Hi, my name is Gracie Gilbert. I'm a sophomore here. My major is pre-med bio with a minor in chemistry, and a bit of the background about how I landed at Ball State was actually because I play soccer here. So during my sophomore year of high school, I was getting heavily recruited by D1 and D2 schools, and then everything changed when I tore my ACL. So one of the schools that was talking to me during this time was called Liberty University, which is off like the East Coast. And so the coach actually switched over to Ball State and is now the head coach here. And so when he found out that I was still not recruited, he reached out to me my senior year of high school and was like, "Hey, would you like to check out Ball State? I think it would be a great fit for you. I think that we'd be honored to have you here as well." And so I checked it out. I loved it. I've actually never been to Ball State and I live in Indiana. So that was very interesting, but I loved it, fell in love with the campus, fell in love with the people, and now I play soccer here. So that's how I got here. So the second question is, given the choice of anyone in the world, whom would I want as a dinner guest? So when thinking of this, I was thinking of like, oh, I could invite Morgan Wallen. Like, I love his music. I love him in general. I'm going to his concert. Very excited for that. But honestly, I'd probably choose a funny person just because I like to be entertained. And I feel like at a dinner, you need to be entertained. So I'd probably choose Will Ferrell. And he's one of my favorite actors. I love him. I think he's very funny. I think he's a very cool dude. Okay, the third question is, if a crystal ball could tell you the truth about yourself, your life, the future, or anything else, what would you want to know? I would honestly probably want to know what kind of job I have in the future. Currently, I want to go to med school and become a pediatrician, but if that does not work out, I want to know what I'm going to do with my life, if I'm going to be a PA, if I'm going to be a nurse, if I'm not going to go into med school at all so I could save my money, stuff like that. So the fourth question is, your house containing everything you own catches fire. After saving your loved ones and your pets, you have time to safely make a final dash to save one item. So the one item I would probably save would be my computer, just because I've destroyed at least 3 computers in my lifetime, and that is very expensive, so I would not want my dad to have to buy me a new one. And also, I have a lot of information that I feel like I cannot restore. I have a lot of like GoPro videos that I used to make, and so those are like memories I just don't want to lose. And I have a lot of like old pictures of me and my friends, so that's like something I wouldn't want to lose. So what is one little known fact about you? Please make this fact creative. So this isn't really about me, but this is about my family. So we currently have a dog named Pablo Escobar. We call him Pablo Escobar after the drug lord. He's actually here with me right now. But another fact about me is that my brother went to the NFL for about a week, and I like to flex this on people because it's a pretty cool fact to go to the NFL. So he was a long snapper and he played for the Colts for a week. And I just wanted to have a jersey that said Gilbert on the back, but that unfortunately did not happen after he got cut. Okay, and then the last question is, what is your biggest self-esteem issue or other issue that you think you might struggle with during this class when giving speeches? So one thing that I struggle with is currently online, like I'm very comfortable with speaking online, but when I speak in person, I tend to get really flustered and I tend to speak really fast. Like I'll talk like this and I'll just go on about every single piece of information that I know. Also in high school, I struggled with like finding the pieces of information that I should actually include into the presentation, because I would like go through all this information and literally try to include every single piece of information, and like that is not good, and that's not how a good presenter speaks. So I think that the biggest thing is going to be talking slow and making sure that people understand me and not memorizing every single thing. And I think one thing that I can do with that is trying to be more comfortable when I speak and trying not to just be like just trying to be comfortable. And I think with that comes practice, and definitely is why this class was made, to practice. But I'm excited to meet all of you guys and hope you enjoyed my question answers.